Hello designers and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to use the stroke width tool, that new tool in version 2.5. Let's get into it. So you've downloaded Affinity Designer 2.5 and now you're wondering, where is this width tool? Because it's not showing in the left hand panel with all the rest of your tools. Well, if you head on up to View, Customize Tools, click on that, and then you head up to this icon here. This is the stroke width tool. You just click on it and drag it in with the rest of your tools. I suggest placing it near your pencil tool or your pen tool up there. As you can see, I've already added it. So after you have added it, just press on close. The long awaited stroke width tool. So what does it allow you to do? Basically, it gives you the ability to edit the pressure profile of your curves. So if we take this curve that I drew out earlier, for instance, I created this using the pencil tool or pen tool you can create it with, and I've given it some thickness. So up here is our stroke panel, and I can drag this slider up and down to give it thickness. But you can notice that it's all the same thickness across there. Previously, we had to head on over to the stroke tab, see up there on the top right, and then we click on the pressure profile there, and I just add a pressure profile point, and I just click and drag down like this, and then I could just keep adding other pressure points, but it was kind of a little bit more difficult not being able to edit it directly on the screen. So this new tool allows us to do that. Before I use that, I just want to show you, it's often overlooked, I think. If you head on up to Help and click on Affinity Designer to Help, you'll see the Help box appears, and I've already typed in Width Tool. So here's all the help you need, all the shortcuts, etc. So don't forget to use that. Okay, let's get into it. So the shortcut for this is W. So if you hit W on your keyboard, you will enter the Stroke Width Tool. Or you could just click on the E icon in the left-hand side. So now that I've clicked on it, I'll zoom in and I'll hover the cursor over the line. You can see as I touch it, there's a little plus icon appears. That means I can add a pressure point. So I will add one about here. Just click once and I'll add one here. Click once again. And you can see there's also these handles on either side. I can click and drag these in to a sharp point, and I can do it with the other side as well. And also you can move these ones out further, or move them along. It looks better in the center. So this is what it allows you to do, and it's much easier to do it on the actual curve itself. And you can see now that I've made those changes, if we go into the pressure profile tab, you can see these are the pressure profiles I've created, and I can drag them up and down from here. So you can see how this correlates to this object here. So let me show you some tips and shortcuts to help you along the way. So if we go down here, I've named them all the shortcuts that you might need. So let's start off with removing a pressure point. Okay, so if I add one here, if I no longer want this anymore, don't want this, I just double tap on the little pressure point node here, just like 1, 2, and it's gone. So I just double tap that node. What's the next one? So it says, shift and drag to modify the width at any point without adjusting its position. So if we head on up, I'll just add another point there. So right now, if I click on it, I can click and it will kind of move around. And let's say I just wanted to make it thicker. In the process of doing that, I might move the point up by accident. So to avoid that, just click on shift and then you can drag it out like this, make it thicker. But look, if I go left and right, it doesn't allow me to. So this is quite handy. Okay, on to the next one. Control and drag to move the point position without adjusting the width. So if I hold down control and I click on this, I can move it sideways. But if I move it up and down, it doesn't affect the thickness. So this can also be very handy. What's the next one? Control and click to manually enter the width required at a chosen point. So up here, I will click on this one. So I'm going to click on control and click, and you see this box appears, set stroke width at point. So I can just type in here 80 pixels, press return, and it's made this point 80 pixels wide. If I hold down shift and then the arrow key on the keyboard, and I just click on the arrow key up, it will go up in 10 pixel increments. Also, if I hold down option and I click up, it will go up in 0.1 pixels. So that's for finer control. You can see the keyboard shortcuts are going a bit crazy there. Anyway, so that's what that allows you to do. and you press OK when you're happy. Now I want to show you more options that we have that are in the context toolbar when we're using the width tool. So if I click on this new curve that I have and I press on W on the keyboard to enter the stroke width tool. If you look in the context toolbar in the top, we have two options. The first one is lock line weight. That's why I've recreated the icon here so you can see what it's about. Basically, this tool allows you to lock a line thickness so you don't go above it. And I'll just show you what I mean. So right now, you can see in the stroke tab up on the top right, it's 80 pixels right now. So if I click on lock line weight right now, and we zoom in and have a look, I will add a pressure point in the middle. If I click on the handle and I try and bring it out further so it gets thicker, it will not allow me. We've locked line weight. It allows me to go further down, but not out. So if I take the option off and I click and drag out, now you can see up in the stroke panel, it's 131 pixels. If I then go and click on lock line weight again, and I add another pressure point, I'm no longer able to go further than that 131 pixel, but I can go further down. So that's what that does. Let's say if you're making something and you don't want it ever to go above that, you just click on the lock line weight. So the next option in relation to the stroke width tool is lock point ordering. I have a new curve here and we're going to try it out. So I'm going to click on W to enter the stroke width tool, and I'm going to head on up to the context toolbar. And we're going to select this one here. This is it, lock point ordering. So if I click on that, basically it allows you to specify whether you want to prevent the tool from dragging from one pressure point past another pressure point along this curve. So let's see how it works. So if I click and drag out this pressure point and I drag it over, and you see there's another pressure point right here. If I try and drag it past there, it will not allow me to do that. But if I head on up and take this off, lock point ordering, I'll uncheck that and I'll click and try again. It effectively swaps over pressure point from left to right, and you can keep going like this. So that's what that tool does. Moving on to the next one. Moving on in the context toolbar, we have two snapping options, and the first being snap to curve nodes. So basically, if we go to our node tool, which is over here, shortcut is A, you can see we have a node either side. If you want to specify where you want these pressure points to end, you can snap to these. So let's click on here, here, and this location here. We've got three nodes here. Now let's switch over to the width tool, the stroke width tool. So I'll click on W. And right now you can't see anything, but if we head on up to snap to curve nodes, I click on that. Now you can see the nodes coming through. So as I start adding the pressure points, there's the first one. I can drag that out and you can see it snaps to the nodes that are on this curve. And I can add another pressure point as well, maybe make it thicker and it will snap to there, and make one more, snap it to the last one. So this is handy if you already know where you want your pressure points to be and they will snap to the nodes on the curve. Okay, let's look at the final snapping option that relates to the stroke width tool. So I have a new stroke here, and we're going to click on W on the keyboard. And we're going to head on up and click on snap to widths on same curve. We're going to click on that. Basically, this will allow us to use snapping to be able to get kind of uniform widths. So let me show you how it works. If I click and add a few pressure points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if I click on this one and drag it out, I will skip over this one and I will click on this pressure point, and I want it to snap to the one on the left. As we have snapping turned on, you see it's activated and it's snapped. So it's exactly the same height. Same goes for this one. If we drag it in, I go over to this pressure point, I can drag it in and eventually it snaps in place. Let's just bring this last one up. Snapped into place. Very handy indeed. Let's move on to an actual design and use everything we've learned. So here's a design I made specifically for oil, where we can use the stroke width tool to somewhat improve this image. So we've got a mountain, a wave, some sea, clouds, a seagull, and sun. So let's go in and use the stroke width tool on the sun first. So on this one, I want to use lock line weight. I'll use that on the seagull too. So I'm going to head on up to the context toolbar. I'm going to select lock line weight. So I'm going to head on in and give it some pressure points. So I'll add one here and I'll add one around there. Now I'll make these two points as thin as they can go. And then I can drag this out. And remember, I cannot go above 10 pixels here because that is, you look at the stroke panel, 10 pixels is the maximum it can go. So I can just choose now where I want this point to be. So it looks the best. I think probably around there looks good. Okay, let's move over to the seagull and use the same thing. Remember, all the settings are still the same. So I will select about here and about there. Now bring the edges in, the two sides on the left and right. I can see that this one isn't in the right place. So because I have this option selected, it allows me to drag without making it thicker. I'll do the same for this side as well. So that worked very well. The next one I'm going to use is lock point ordering, this one here. And we're going to go on this really thick curve here, this thick stroke. This is 33 pixels, this one. So I'm going to go up to the context toolbar again. I'm going to click on lock point ordering. So I'll zoom in and start adding some pressure points. I'm going to make kind of a Christmas tree here. So I'll add a point there and a point there. I'll add another point there. Let's see how this works. But the top one I want to be pointy, so I'm going to drag that in. This point, pressure point here, I want to drag it in and I want to drag it up. Because I've got it locked, it will not go past that pressure point there. So I'll do the same with this one as well. Drag it in and up to about there. Maybe I'll make that slightly thinner. And I'll add a couple more points here actually. So drag that out so it's thicker, up and in like that. In fact, these can be slightly thinner now, can't they? You see, it's really helping me because I can just drag it down and past that pressure point. There we go. Got a Christmas tree down there. Okay, what's next on the list? Snap two widths on same curve. So here we have a cloud and this is the bottom of the cloud. Again, we go up to the context toolbar. I'll uncheck the last one. And I'll select snap two widths on same curve. Let's zoom in and start applying them. So I'll add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 maybe. The edges I want to be super thin. And these ones I want to be just slightly thinner, like that. So the next point I want over here, I want it to snap to this really thin one. So if I bring it down slowly, you see it snapped into place. Now I can just drag this a little bit. And there we go. If you don't like the thickness, remember you don't have to do it individually. You could just go up to stroke, click on the thickness, and just slide it down slightly like that. So the next one we're going to use is snap to curve nodes. And on the wave, we have a few curves here. And I've already added a couple of nodes to them. So I'll show you via the node tool, which is A. There they are. I've placed one here and here. I want the pressure points to be snapping to those. So I'll click on the stroke width tool and I'll go up and we'll select this one here, snap to curve nodes. That one is selected. Also, I want to make sure that they don't go above 10.5 pixels, which it is right now, that line. But I'm also going to check lock line weight. And now let's go in and have a look. But remember, they are nodes, they're not pressure points. So I'm going to add a pressure point here and over here. Now I'll make both left and right as thin as they can be. There we go. And now the pressure point, I want it to snap to this one here. So as I've locked the line weight, I can just drag it out and I'm not worried that it's going to get thicker. So that snapped to that section and this pressure point is now snapped to there. And I can continue doing that with all of them, just clicking and dragging down, making sure they snap into place. Okay, that's looking a lot better. So what else should we do? Let's go and sort these mountains out. So with this one, I'm just going to take all of these off. Snap to curve nodes, like that. I'm going to take all of them off. So I'll click a pressure point about here because I want it to be going a lot thinner down there. Now it still looks a bit thick here, so I'll just bring this in just ever so slightly. And I'll do the same with these points over here. Okay, let's sort the clouds out now. So if I click on it, click on W to enter the stroke width tool, I'll add a pressure point around here. And we can start using those other shortcuts we talked about before. So I can just drag this in like that. With this pressure point, I can hold down Control, click, and I can just move it around, and I'm not worried that it's going to make it thicker or thinner. It's just allowing me to move this point around like that. So I'll have it about there, I think. And I'll do the same for the other side. I'll add a pressure point there, and I'll bring that in, and then I'll hold Control, click. I want to make it thinner. Let's bring it all the way up there. Yeah, I'm happy with that. So we can use the same thing here as well. In fact, let's use the Shift function. So I'll add a pressure point here and over on this side, and I'll just drag in slightly. And let's say this section here, I'm going to click on Shift because I just want to drag this thicker and I don't want it to go left and right. And then I can make the rest thinner. So I hold down Shift, drag, Shift, drag. Although it looks strange, at least I used the shortcut, right? Okay, what else have we got? I think I will just finalize it by going around and just placing pressure points and just trying to make it look good. So on this one, I can hold down Control. I've added a pressure point. I'm going to hold Control and click and just drag it over here because I don't want to make it thicker. So I can do that with all of these. Control, drag, click, drag down, Control, drag. And lastly, I'm going to apply a few pressure points and I'm going to purposefully delete one just so you can see that I'm using all of the things I've shown you. So I will add an extra one here. Yep, I don't need that anymore. So I'll just double tap. I've gotten rid of that pressure point. The only thing I haven't done is I haven't pressed Control, clicked, so I could enter it manually like this, but I will just for the sake of the tutorial. So I'm just using the arrow keys up and down. Press OK and complete. And that concludes another Affinity Designer tutorial. If you made it to the end, well done, congratulations. If you have any comments, just leave it in the comments section. And if you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and do that. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.